set of circumstances, it's not apples and oranges, and we can't even use the same model. To that end, District 7, which is our district for Caltrans, is very interested in a little vision. They don't want it. It's coming up with the money. The estimates they have, the engineering, are ridiculous. They're very high. So when I talked to Tim Mahoney, we were going to set up a meeting with District 7 with Carrie and our group at the bid and someone from Mitch's office to find out how we can get those numbers down and what is the solution to paying for it. Because Caltrans will not pay for all of it, and the city doesn't have money. There is CRA money available from the last bond that Eric got approved, the very last of the CRA money, and I don't know, since this relinquishment was not an approved project of CRA, if we can capture any of that money. That's what I'm working on now, because there's a lot of money that they need for the 15 districts. And if we could siphon off some of that from the Holiday area to pay for the city's share, then we could get relinquishment done right away. But the power lines will not be there as part of relinquishment. I know it makes more sense. It's hard to compare. West Hollywood is a city of 30,000. We're a city of 4 million. You can't compare the two cities and how they got things done. They had Edison, we have DWP. It's just all different. And
in reality, those weren't even tied together in West Hollywood.
But Edison did pay. They paid.
Right.
Our DWP.
It wasn't the same project. It was two different projects in West Hollywood.
I know, but they paid very. We don't have anyone who paid for there.
Correct.
But we can get it. So if we're holding out to bury it, we'll never get relinquishment done. So if you want relinquishment, then we need to just move forward. But if it's going to be tied to burying the power lines, we'll never get it. Because they can't just do our bid. They have to do all of them. And there is not money for that.
Unless you get the stakeholders to agree to a bond.
Yes, that is correct.
Or Rule 20.
But, you know,
or Rule 20.
Rule 23?
That's where the municipalities hold the companies of burial.
Rule 23 is the maximum decimal. So, Eric,
so they don't bury the power line. What do we benefit by not relinquishing some of our choice?
The city, the city then has control of Santa Monica Boulevard.
And of course, our medallions are working.
You can put your medallions in.
Only for the city.
Sorry, I'm only leaving this comment.
Hey, so yeah? We can get into this really quick. Dan O'Hanley was supposed to be here to talk about this. Did you guys see this very successful press event that happened recently where we can stop when Tom comes in and then we'll pick it back up. But it's really important for us to get a level of support.
Yeah. I said the light.
Okay, really quick. So, Equity Actors, the union, is trying to now reverse something that's been longstanding since the 80s, where 99-seat theater and under, they waived the union rules. So now suddenly they're trying to make these small theaters pay union.
Equity waiver.
And it sounds good to give people minimum wage.
I used to work for Equity.
Okay. So Daniel is requesting that the board issue a letter of support to the I Love 99 organization campaign so that these theaters are allowed to maintain their community base and have volunteers and all these people participate like they've been participating since the 80s. If you watch the news and you saw this presser, it was about Noel Wiley and Tim Robbins and Francine Fisher, I think is her name, and lots of others, and people that come and dedicate their time to local theater are really invested in making sure that these small theaters remain viable and retain the ability to have local community driven volunteers and actors. So in our effort, it's right in line with our effort to support local theater. So,
and if you look at ABC News, sorry to cut you off, there was 300 people protesting the ADA. It was a lot of names. So Peter Rowe is going to get a lot more press and looked at. And what Stephen's talking about when he has like the $3,000 for landscaping is because we have neglected palette that's getting stared at right now. And you know, Peter Rowe has been banding together. They've been meeting, I'd say, consistently for about what, 7-8 months now, something like that. A lot of stuff is coming. They would be happy to monitor any type of things that are going on in Santa Monica, you know, with the plan design. So if you guys really think about what that is, I know it's the media district. I know we have a lot of studios. But right now, there's a lot of talk about theater row and small theater, and if they do vote yes on the 99 proposal, they'll probably sue the union and still go forward and still have things. So theater row, I don't think it can dissipate one way or the other because there's so much hype on it, and it's band together more than I've seen in maybe two, you know, I haven't been there that long, but decades.
I can tell you that the North Hollywood Arts District, there was a large protest there the other day in support of their local theaters too. So there is a precedent for it. It's about supporting a local business in our area. I think it's a good idea for us to issue a very brief supportive letter about I Like 99. So I'm asking that somebody, if there's discussion, discuss it. Somebody would like to make a motion, please.
I'd like to make a motion to support the I Love 99 campaign called Save Small Theater Everywhere.
I'll second. Who's second?
Okay. All
of them? Okay.
There was a motion.
You have a motion and you have a second. All in favor of sending a letter of support? Thank you, guys. Opposed? Abstained? Motion carried.
If I can say this one thing, it's very important. We are supporting it. I know I'm for you, I deal with labor, so I should be in support of it. But the reason why I'm in support of it is because Theater Row is one of our big deals here in our district. We've spent a lot of time creating these medallions for it and everything else like that. If this thing passes and goes in equity's favor, if these theaters can't afford to pay these assets, we are not going to have Theater Row. So,
I'm sorry to be kind of taken away from us by the Hollywood Arts Council anyway. So they're like the subcommittee now of the Hollywood Arts Council.
I feel the adjournment coming and I feel the council coming. So I would just like to revisit this whole thing about the time of our meeting. The four of us here kind of would prefer 3 p.m. Perhaps we can have a vote on this. 3 o'clock? No, we're not doing anything now. We just, would you prefer 3? Who likes 3? Who likes 4?
What might be helpful is if we can just go around and get it. And
you want to do this now?
Just take it out. Okay. Right now. Joseph, 3 or 4? 3.
Ladies and gentlemen, I need to interrupt.
All right.
I would like to introduce you to our councilman.
So let me just read this. Thank you, Tom LaBonge. The Hollywood media did proudly recognizes the incomparable Tom Clark for more than 40 years of exemplary service to the city of Los Angeles, of Council District 4, and for being the heart and soul of our great city. You're an inspiration to all of us. You will always be our councilman.
We'll do that. Let's take a picture. Group shot.
All right. Group shot.
And I'm going to tell you another story. I had our sister city program, and I was in France. This one for this one. And I'm in France because Bordeaux is our sister city. And Jim Omahan, the mayor of Bordeaux, he tries to explain in translation what a councilman is. And he doesn't get it right before the first day. It was a 5-day, 15-year celebration, but 5-day trip. Within the first day, he said, forget it. I'm not going to call you councilman. And they gave me the nice title of the mayor of Hollywood. One dinner, one measure, 356 selfies.
Everybody.
Bitch, never out. Now the bitch. Sharon, remind me
of this end, so we're balanced.
A little tight.
Good job.
There we go. That's looking good.
Look right here, Bruce.
I saw that.
Look right here.
That's still good. It's still good. Keep it coming. Just,
just keep it coming.
Keep those smiles coming.
All right. Okay.
Some other jokes then.
Okay, we're good.
Great. Now we have a cake for you.
Make sure you take the council members for
a free shot.
For everybody the fees, too.
Okay, so thank you for the trees.
Good. Can I just tell you what's so important about the bid area? Everybody knows Hollywood. It's good works, it's where the work is done. And all the activity and all the transformation. And the nicest thing I'm just telling you this is the housing that has been built is over at Wilcox and Hudson and some of those streets. The empty nesters who live in Hancock Park still want to stay in the neighborhood because their temple, their church, their friends, their swim club, their country club, whatever it is, the golf courses, is in the neighborhood. And that is transformed these neighborhoods. For the neighborhood to get better, this neighborhood is being transformed. All the possibility, the north end of Larchmont is now really happening. So all this is good. It's a thank yourself being on a board, but you make a difference. Because if you weren't here, nobody would be here. And so thank you. It's a lot of fun.
Thank you.